time the Olympics comes up, you think, wow, what can we do to be new? And Munich had a very beautifully conceived park. Everything's all of one hand, all a similar design, and that worked beautifully. London's more heterogeneous, and actually the main athletes and the main activities were concentrated here on the park. But even then, the theory was to only have three or four permanent buildings: the main stadium, the swimming and the aquatics, the cycling, and then a general purpose arena. Everything else will be taken away afterwards because there's no long-term proposition which requires that, even in a city of 8-10 million people like London.
Die Situation in London ist, und das haben wir hier auch gesehen und werden es noch sehen, die ist ja schon sehr anders. London ist eine Stadt mit unglaublich viel Entwicklungspotenzial. Ich möchte jetzt nicht sagen, dass München eigentlich fertig ist, aber es gibt in München nirgendwo solche Ecken, wie wir sie hier eigentlich sehen. Also dass man immer wieder neue Konversionsflächen hat, die sind ja in München relativ handverlesen. Von daher, glaube ich, kann man es nicht wirklich vergleichen.
So we really wanted to design the building backwards. So we had this phrase, which was to think of the velodrome to be for after the games, and that the games was like a housewarming party, and only a party. We wanted to build the house for afterwards. So we thought about everything back to front.
Was natürlich, also auf jeden Fall von London gelernt werden kann, ist dieser Blick in die Zeit nach den Spielen, also dass wirklich ganz klar die Entwicklung so gesehen wurde, nicht nur für die 17-tägige Periode der Spiele und der Paralympics, sondern dass man tatsächlich so plant, dass man schon in die Zukunft blickt. Und das ist sicherlich etwas, was ganz, ganz wichtig ist, wenn man solche großen Events in Zukunft in die Stadt holen will.
And we looked at all sorts of reductions in energy, in water use, and integrated those into the architecture and the engineering.
Und natürlich ist auch der Olympische Park ein immer noch grünes Herz für München. Aber das Thema Nachhaltigkeit war damals noch nicht so ausgesprochen eigentlich. Und es ging tatsächlich mehr darum, also dieses freie, heitere, demokratische und soziale Leben in Deutschland nach dem Zweiten Weltkrieg zu zeigen.
Legacy, legacy, legacy is a really important component to winning a bid and then winning public support.
One thing we have got here, as well as a great sporting spectacle, was a chance to stitch together the east and the west of London and to help regenerate a really forgotten part of the city. And that can hopefully, you know, lead on to economic regeneration in this area.
In the summer, in terms of UK GDP, there was about 0.4-0.5% increase in GDP over the Olympic summer period. So in terms of economic boost to the country during that time, that was significant. UK construction and international companies involved working on big infrastructure project like that obviously created a lot of jobs. And then, of course, now that will create more jobs and more work and homes for people post games between now and 2040.
I think you'll have to come back in 20 years and see what's happened to this area. And hopefully this moment has been pivotal in just swinging the pendulum a bit from the established west of London, which is wealthy and historic, to bringing some new investment into the east.